Okay, this is part five, and at the end of part four, I made a little mistake. I left a couple of bodies suppressed, so the proper edge count is 231, and that is after suppressing the two little edges that shouldn't be there. So I exported a parasolid from my CAD system and X11. And I imported that into System F. This time I did not open it in Design Modeler. I went straight into meshing. And I meshed individual parts, so they're not a multi-body part, but it was successful at meshing each individual part, and it was able to use hex meshing everywhere except that one face. There's something going on down here, and here we see there is a geometry problem when I turn mesh defeaturing off in the mesh settings, mesh defeaturing set to no. This is a geometry error in the geometry, and it should have been cut more precisely. So there was probably an extrude that went down and did not properly intersect the corner. So that's a geometry error that could be repaired, and it might help meshing. This has a good connection. So, and that's just a lack of sharing common edges. And this has a tremendously tight, ridiculously tight mesh at the center. Can't even zoom into that. Let's try it with the mouse. The space mouse is misbehaving. I mean, it's not terrible, actually. So maybe that's acceptable. Yep. So there you have it. I can now go and convert that into a multi-body part, and with mesh defeaturing, that corner might be taken care of in meshing. In fact, let's just do it now. Turn that to yes, and we'll note the 0.25 e to the minus 2 millimeters. So we will let's just remesh. Update. Okay, it finished updating, and let's return to this area. Fran, that is a place to go back and improve the quality of the slicing. So that extrude actually needed to be a revolve to that vertex there. And then there will be a clean intersection of three bodies here instead of this little mess in the corner. So that's the recommendation for this video, and we'll wrap it up there.